Hi. Ever wonder who decides which artwork goes on the walls of the museum? Today we talk with a curator at the Guggenheim Museum. Check out this episode of Sketch with Jeff.
One, two.
It's Mr. Jeff. It's Mr. Jeff. And his show.
And pencil, too. It's Sketch with Jeff.
Oh, that's a lot. Oh, hi. Welcome to Sketch with Jeff. As always, I'm really excited to see you. I've got a whole armful of artwork created by my helper, Pencil. She's been working very hard, making drawings and paintings, and looks like a whole portfolio of art. She wants to do something with it. I'm not sure what, but she asked me to get it out of the closet and bring it to her. So let's check in with her, see what she's up to. Pencil? What's going on, Pencil?
I have so much artwork. I want to have an exhibition, but I don't know how to make one.
Yes, you should show people your art.
Where do I begin?
Great question.
An art exhibition, that's really exciting. You know, I'm not much of an expert at that, but I know someone who is. Maybe she can help. Let's go to the Guggenheim Museum and see if we can find my friend who knows all about exhibitions. Come on, let's go.
Megan!
Hi, Jeff. Hi.
I thought I might find you here.
Where else?
In the galleries, of course. I love that we have a chance to talk to you and meet with you today. What is it like being a curator?
There's lots of different things I do as a curator, but I think what I enjoy the most is my role as a storyteller. So really finding a way to translate the story of a single object, a group of objects, a whole exhibition and tell that story to our audience.
So you're telling a story, but you're not using words. You're actually using the objects as a way of showing the story.
And every artwork has a story to tell. You know what? I started out as a maker. I think a lot of people do. I like to sketch. I like to draw, paint, create things. And then I liked learning about how other people were creating things. Hey, let me show you one of my favorite paintings in the gallery.
I would love that.
Great.
Lead the way.
Let's go. I actually went to the site where this painting was painted. I was able to travel to France, to the very site where this painting was painted. And then part of that, I said, why don't I go to the site and walk in someone else's shoes and see the blue sky he saw, see the land that he saw. And it was, I have to say, really exciting. Do you know what else I love, Jeff? I love that it's not finished entirely, especially down here. You can see he started painting, he left some patches empty, he was experimenting, he was trying things out. We don't have to be perfect at all. And I love that. Once I spend some time on this painting and another painting and a different set of artists, I go to my trusty models.
What are these?
These are tiny little dollhouse maquettes. I have a whole bunch of these paintings, so some are quite large, some are smaller. And I start to get a feel for what conversations might come out of this, what paintings talk to each other, what stories unfold. And I start to play in my dollhouse, so to speak.
So you have a little version of the room that we're in here?
Exactly. I have brilliant colleagues who have constructed a mini model of our galleries and mini maquettes of the paintings. I always go back to the artwork and see what it has to tell me. Well, you know what, Jeff? I have a surprise for you. I was thinking about Pencil and thinking about how I make exhibitions, and I put together this model for Pencil with some of her artwork on the walls.
That's Pencil's artwork. There's her self-portrait right there in a frame. This is absolutely beautiful. So you looked at her work and you decided or figured out what stories could be told through her work?
Exactly. It's just a start. We'll keep at it.
Can't thank you enough. This is really beautiful. Pencil is going to be shocked when she sees this in person. Thanks for sharing all this information.
My pleasure. Come visit me again soon in the galleries. You know where to find me.
I know where to find you. Somewhere around here and maybe in front of Cezanne. I'm so inspired by our conversation with Megan and this work of art by the artist Cezanne. I have an idea for an art project back in the studio and I'd love to show it to you. So come with me, let's go to the studio and let's make some art, come on.
I decided that I'm going to sketch my day
And I'm going to do that in little tiny sketches. So I'm making some small rectangles and squares on a piece of drawing paper. Then I'm going to draw things that I do, like things that I eat, yummy waffles, or things that I see, like this really cool tree near the Guggenheim Museum. I'm going to pay attention, colors in the sky, or even small details, things that I wear, I can draw. Then after I draw all of these sketches, I cut them out. And I'm going to make little frames for them. I really loved the frames that Megan had on her maquettes. And, well, I have this box. I actually put white paper on the inside of this little box, and I'm going to make a mini gallery, playing with where things should go, the arrangement of all of my sketches from the day. And then in the end, I have an exhibition of my day. It's an exhibition that shows the story of me and my day today.
I'm back at the studio. I gave Megan's gift to Pencil. Let's check in with Pencil, see how she's doing. Pencil, what's going on?
Thank you, Megan, for this amazing gift. I can almost imagine my exhibition. Welcome to my art exhibition.
Pencil, your artwork is magnificent.
Thank you. It tells my story.
An art exhibition? That's so exciting. Stay tuned for more episodes of Sketch with Jeff to see if Pencil actually has her exhibition. In the meantime, it's really fun to look through her old artwork, see what she's been up to. Wait a second. What's this? A painting titled Jeff? I think that's me. She did a great job. And I really like being part of her story. I'll see you soon. Bye.
One, two.
It's Mr. Jeff. It's Mr. Jeff. It's Mr. Jeff. It's Mr. Jeff. And his show.
And Pencil, too. It's Sketch with Jeff.